In this video, I will present to you five areas that you can work on if you'd like to improve your double pooling technique. The first one is the pool plant, and we know from science and from experience that the best skiers in the world are putting the pools into the snow in an almost vertical position. And we know also, if we compare elite skiers with a novel skier or a skier at a little bit lower level, the skiers at the highest level will always put the pools into the snow longer in front of the bindings than skiers at a lower level. And we also know that the skiers at the higher level are regulating actively where in the snow they are putting the pools. And we also see that it's not about where the spits of the pool is into the snow, but also how far away from the body they are putting them into the snow. So this is an important part to work with and to experiment with, and it's dependent on, of course, of the speed and the terrain, and also of your own strengths. But you should always try to adjust this pool plant to the terrain and speed, of course. On this picture, we see this year's winner of the Vasaloppet for the women, and we see also that the women's are doing this strategy by putting the pools into the snow in a vertical position like this. When we go to the next point, the flexion extension pattern in shoulder and elbow is a very important way to work if you would like to make this pool plant as an advantage for you. If you put force on the pools when they are standing like this, you will get a reaction force that goes the opposite direction, also working vertically. And that will not bring you forward. So the skiers are not doing that. They are doing flexion and extension in the shoulder and elbow. And you see when she's going on with the upper body now, she goes down and into like a compression. And you see that the elbow is flexed all the way, and the fingers are into the head. And when she had done this, she have like stretched the muscles that are going to do the double pooling stroke with the arms, and it rises the speed and force of the arms into the pools and into the snow. So this is an important way of working if you'd like to improve your double pooling technique. The third focus area is about the fall in the body and how much you should go up on your toes. And the first thing you have to consider is how strong are you, and also what kind of distance are you skiing on. If you're doing a very long distance, then it probably costs too much to do this. And if you are going like a sprint, or you are doing acceleration, or passing another skier, or doing an attack in the track, you probably have to do it to raise the speed enough. But as you see on this, the three skiers on the video, you see this guy over here has quite a lot of fall, and you see the one on this side is not so much, and it's got kind of a little bit different strategy here also, and it's very often comes because you're focused on getting hip forward. But all the three skiers on these videos are quite extreme in the fall, and it will probably not be able to do this for a longer distance. So when we are talking about the fall and how much you should go up on your toes, it's important to consider the distance we are going. So if you have an acceleration or a sprint or an attack, you maybe have to be extreme both in fall and how much you go up on your toes. If you are in a competition speed, like a normal 15k like an interval with long intervals, like 8 minutes or something like that, you maybe have a moderate fall and moderate up on your toes. And if you do a long distance race, like Visma Ski Classic or a longer one, or you do a long distance slow training session, you you may be about just go up a little limited, if you can call it. And there is also important that you wait, if you are going up on your toe and you are into a fold, that you wait to go up on your toes until the arms are in the position. If not, you will probably get too late with the arms, and you will be down on the heels again before the pools are going into the snow, and then there is no idea of doing it. So if you see the skiers closest to the camera, this skier here, you see that when the pools are coming into snow, he is already down on your heels again. So this will not help him very much. It will cost a lot. So you always have to have this cost-benefit thinking around how much fall, how much up on your toe. It's not only working with the fall. It has to be a combination. And also, if you look at the winner of Vasaloppe, this is right when she was catched by the boys and she starting following them. And you see that she's not up on her toes, and she has almost no fall in the body at all. You see, at once when the upper body starts going down, the hip goes backwards, and she doesn't have any fall. But she does the flexion extension pattern in the upper body and the elbow. So this is the important part. The fall, and it depends on speed, the distance, how strong you are you, how strong are your stomach muscles, because it's very demanding for the stomach and back muscles to have a great fall forward. And also, you will use a lot of energy if you go up on your toe, you don't do it right. So if you will go up on your toes, you have to wait until the pools are in the position, and then you go up, and then it brings you a better position. And at the national skiers, it normally looks like we see on the skiers here, the pools are angled quite much backwards, and you see that the elbows and the underarms are going down at once without any extension flexion pattern into the snow, and you see there is just going backwards like this. And just look at the elbows, you see, go down, and it works like just with the extension of the movement, not the extension after a flexion. And we see also here is the area is quite flat, a good fall in the body, and you put the pools into the snow, and then in a vertical position, and then you see there is almost no extension flexion pattern in the shoulders or. The fourth area that they will put focus on is the repositioning phase. When you're finished with the double pulling stroke, you need to be fast into the next double pulling stroke. And to do that, you has to have your body weight on the forefoot and not on your heels. Sorry. So you put pressure on your toes and not on your heels. And when you have pressure in front of the foot, you will be able to go directly to the next stroke. If you have the body weight on your heels, you have no other possibilities than go straight up. And then you may make the fall afterwards. So here's in the sprint against the goal. And she has the body weight distributed on both heels and toes, I suppose. But she's able to go directly into the next stroke. And we would like to short down the time we spent on repositioning. because this is a face without any forward pulsation from arms or feet. So we think that when you're finished with the stroke, you should have the pressure on the forefoot and not on your heels. The area I would like to pay attention to is the three-step rocket. And I say this because it's about the right recruitment of recruitment pattern of the muscles that are used and the segments of the body that are in use. The first rocket is your stomach and your upper body. And as you see on the skier on the film, that you have a high position and he starts the movement by using the stomach and going on the pulls without using the arms. Just arms are not moving. And the next rocket is when we start moving the upper arm against your hip or against your back. And you see that it goes backwards like this. Stomach and upper arm. Step one, step two. And the third part, if the uphill is not too steep, you can release the underarm, who is the third step of the rocket, and the underarm goes backwards like this. So we had just a short one there, but the higher speed it becomes, the more you can use the underarm. Flat area, high speed, then also the third step of the rocket can be double pulling technique that is supposed to bring you up the uphills. You have to be compact. The pulls are close to the center of the body mass. The pulls are into the snow quite close to the bindings. And you are compact working with your body. And you are like pumping yourself up with the feet. The five-step rocket. 1. Pull plant. 2. Flexion extension pattern in shoulder and elbow. 3. Fall in the whole body and how much you should go up on the toe. 4. Is the repositioning. And 5. Is the 3-step rocket for recruiting the right muscle at the right time.